Right, so you got your new Flipper Zero and you want to install original firmware on it. I'm not sure why would you do so, but okay, here's my new transparent Flipper. I'll need USB-C to USB cable and I'll turn it on for the first time right now. Here we go. It says, hey mate, press right arrow to continue. Allow me to introduce myself. And here is the name. Apparently, he is a cyber dolphin living in my pocket. Oh well, then he will be living right next to another fish in my pants. Anyway, it is nice little intro from Flipper. Let's connect USB-C cable to the Flipper and another end to the PC. Now we can visit link written on packaging. Update.flipper0.1. Here we can download QFlipper or Flipper app. I'll stick with the QFlipper as app uses Bluetooth. Boom! This is QFlipper. It detects connected Flipper and display its info, so we have no SD card and database is missing. Let's see, hit update and we need SD card. So let's pop in this SanDisk 32GB Extreme SD card with terminals facing up. By the way, make sure to subscribe and I'll continue with video. It still says SD not present. Let's see again. Fail. Oh, but now it's okay. It is weird bug. It will tell what's going to be installed. Update again. From now on is process automatic. Keep Flipper connected and let QFlipper and Flipper do their things. If you want to see how to install custom firmware such as Unleashed, Extreme or Rogue Master, check out my other videos and also check description for some useful links. Flipper will reboot several times during update, so don't panic as long as the progress bar is, I guess, progressing? Once done, you will see success and happy Flipper giving you thumbs up. In QFlipper, you will see latest firmware version and no updates written below. Now all is finished and ready. As you can see on screen, Flipper is ready to be used. You can safely disconnect the USB-C cable and start using your new Flipper Zero. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video.